Hey everyone, what's going on? Welcome to this new unboxing video where we won't unbox one watch but two. Both are Armanis. One is the Armani Exchange, that's Armani's lesser expensive line, so to say. And the other is Emporio Armani. Now, the Emporio Armani retails at 330 euros. This one retails at 200 euros. This is the Armani Exchange Drexler AX2600. This is the AR1808. Both are chronographs, and I want to do this unboxing together so you can really see if the variance in price, you know, is worth it. You know, for the Emporio you pay 130 euros more, so you expect a more premium packaging than the Exchange line. So I will unbox at the same time, step by step, and you know, we will see if you get your value for your money, or that maybe you're overpaying for this one. Well, we will find out. If you like my videos, please subscribe and give a thumbs up. You know, I got way more videos coming up. I will also do a review video on both of them. If you have any questions or suggestions about these watches, please leave a comment below and I will get back at them in the review video. So now let's get over to the exciting part, you know, the unboxing. So now we'll get to the fun part of the video. So the unboxing, and I'm really curious to see how the Emporio watch compares to the Exchange watch. First thing notice, somehow this one is sealed in plastic, this one isn't. So yeah, let's get started, you know, the first step, just to slide it out. It's a bit... Ah, there we go. For this one, I guess they used the plastic to save down on the cardboard, like it's here. Like the plastic here is the same use as the cardboard, it seems. All right. So first thing that we notice, remember for this watch, you pay about 120 euros more. This one is just a cardboard box. Feels kind of cheap, to be honest. This one is more firm, it slides up. Let's see what we find inside. Which one should we start with? Okay, let's go with the Emporio. Ah, very nice box inside. Gives a bit of the... It's a brushed metal look, but it feels kind of soft. It's not metal, but I like the brushed look already. And here you can slide this one off. Let's see what you find here. Ah. So put this one in a box, clearly a different box. You see they just printed the name on it. certainly I prefer this one a lot more so far. So inside we also have the booklet. Some protection foil booklet. And of course the certificate of authentication. I better not mix them up. We have like a more curved box and also a booklet. No certificate in it, certificate of authentication yet. Authenticity, maybe it's inside. I'm actually surprised there's a booklet in the cheaper version, because you would say, you know, they would skip it to save on material costs. Just the instructions are inside of it. Your Armani book, kind of the same. This one definitely more like, how it feels more premium, you know. If you look at how its material is made. So far the Emporio watch is making up its increase in money. The boxes themselves, yeah, it's a curved look, Armani Exchange. They also maybe aim at a more younger crowd than Emporio line. If you're in your 20s, I think this one is maybe more appealing. It's a nice, unique design. This is more the classical look. The brushed steel look, it's actually soft. Plastic case. It does also feel more firm than this one. No, this one is... It's nicely done, but you can see that, you know, they're really saved on the quality of it, I guess. Oh, let's open them again.
Certificato di Autenticità. We know that it's both are real. Good to know. First thing I notice, you know, because how it's open. Here you already notice it's. It doesn't open very smooth. And also, you know, because of the shape of it, can be a bit difficult. This one, very smooth. Way better. Both are put in plastic covers for protection, it seems. But this one has like a nice bracelet. Wall watch is covered in the plastic. Pull it out here. The exchange watch. They put it on a nice pillow. But yeah, the plastic it's in, it's just like pushed in a bag and it's done. This one, yeah, it gives a more premium look, of course. Yeah, you really feel that this one is it's just a production work. No, put it in, done. And this one is way, way nicer. This watch does come on a pillow. It feels very, very cheap. Retails 200 euros. Well, if it's worth the money or not, we'll get back at it later. As you can see, this one retails at 330 euros. So there's even a 130 euro difference, not 120 like I mentioned before. What also pays my attention is that this bracelet is all like plastified, plastic on it. Maybe because it was in a cheaper box or something. They needed additional protection. This one hasn't got it. Yeah. So my first overall impressions so far are you can really see why you pay more for this watch. You know, you see the packaging, you know, the quality premium packaging. This one is more like cheaper and simple packaging. And also, you know, the quality is different. Let's turn on the chronograph functions of both. Reset. Perfect. Yeah, what I also noticed, I don't know if you can also see it, is that the second marker on this watch is more precise on where it should be. Almost straight on top of it. With this one, it's a bit off, you see? It's a bit off. Overall, also the buttons here to press. Yeah, this one here, way more room to wiggle around with it than this one. Let's try to set the time. It goes. You also notice here, you know, if you move it fast, there's a bit of playing on it, you know. Oh wow, this, yeah. So if you first set the time with this one and then you move to this watch, you really feel the difference a lot, to be honest. You see, it's also very direct. If I quickly turn it, this one wouldn't move direct on it. Each watch I will discuss further in their individual review of videos. Oh, look at this bracelet. I'm not sure if like this look on me, to be honest. Maybe it's a bit feminine, but it's something different than the usual watch. The ending. In my review video, I'll get back to it, how it is when you wear it. I hope it doesn't make that much noise. But to come to a conclusion, €330, €200. You certainly notice the price difference in the Emporio one. Better quality, not only in the boxing, the packaging, also the watch itself. My first impressions are like it's much better. For this €200 watch, I like the design of it, to be honest. You have also Armani Exchange watches, which are also chronograph, for around €150. That's maybe a more fairer price, but this one has the cooler design, the AX. The cheap ones has fully Armani Exchange spelled out, ruining the design in my opinion. Also what they did in the center, you know, the vertical lines. So the design part here looks really nice. The edge is a bit too thick in my opinion. It also feels quite heavy. I don't know if that also has to do with the quality of steel. But yeah, for example, the Hugo Boss chronograph feels much lighter and smoother. You also see a bit in the edges here. The edges are a bit more rough, less polished, you know, a bit sharper edges, so to say. This one, you know, you see it, you know, it's way smoother. It's actually, I'm not a fan of the strap, but you know, if you look at the bezel itself, it looks very smooth. I think it would be better to have maybe just a normal leather strap on it, maybe black. So is this one worth €200? Maybe I personally would say 170 is a better price for this watch compared to how the packaging look like and you know, the quality of the watch itself. This one worth €330. Maybe it's a bit more because also of the special bracelet here. Around €300 is mostly a fair, a usual price for these kind of watches from the fashion brands, the chronographs. The plate is a bit simple, you know, they even put just the markers on it. So yeah, €330. Also would aim this a bit lower, around 300 to 280. If you can get it this for on sale for maybe a 30% discount or maybe even 50 when it's an outlet, it would be a good buy for that money, I think. The battle Armani Exchange versus Emporio Armani. Definitely Emporio Armani. You know, I like the packaging a lot more. The design is a lot better. You know, when you buy Armani, you know, you expect a certain amount of quality, no matter if it's the lesser expensive Exchange line or the premium Emporio line. You know, this one really gives you the Armani experience, in my opinion. This watch, it's nothing special. You know, it's just maybe the same as every watch in the €150 price category. So, yeah. I like this a lot more. Please let me know your opinion in the comments. Maybe you prefer this one a lot more for the money, the €200 you pay for this one. Let me know in the comments. Also, anything you want to know about this watch, please ask and I will get back to it in their review videos. For now, thank you for watching. Please subscribe and I will see you in my next videos.